Dak, Nostra Whitlock, and Marcellus Wiley.
We in Vegas next week, too.
Yeah.
Money man on him.
The blackjack table.
Joined now by a couple of former Pro Bowlers, Sean Merriman and Cliff Averill. Time now for a big story. Let's move to Dallas, where Dak Prescott is entering the last year of his rookie contract and is expected to get a big extension from the Cowboys any day now. But not everyone thinks that would be such a great idea, with Pro Football Focus arguing that Jerry Jones should cut bait with Dak, who they say hasn't shown much development since his rookie year, and could hamstring the team with a massive new deal. I think this is a little bit harsh. A little bit harsh. I said a little bit harsh, but Marcel, I'm gonna throw it to you.
Yeah.
Crazy idea for the Cowboys to move on from Dak.
It's not crazy, man. It's crazy to think about their real problem, which is an abundance of riches in terms of talent. They got a lot of players that are going to look for some big paydays coming up soon. And Dak Prescott, where does he fall in that pecking order? He gets kind of low if you start to think about his performance. You want to hear something harsh? Boy. You don't want to argue with Pro Football Focus. I just tell you, I'm just saying, I'm so glad I retired before this thing came out. Boy, they will break you down.
Man.
And they get it right. They called him, and I quote, profoundly average quarterback. A profoundly average quarterback who's basically dressed up with a defense and a running game. Everything else is putting lipstick on this pig, as they want to say it. I like Dak. I really like Dak. I don't love Dak to the tune of his floor is now $30 million, and his ceiling may exceed Carson Wentz and get into the mid-30s in terms of annual salary. So I think just because of all the talent they have and the fact that maybe you can roll the dice and win a different way at that position, it won't be crazy if they let him go.
You know, I hate to say this because... No, I do. Because I love to see guys get paid. I'm an advocate. I'm always about, hey, when you've been playing well and you earned it, I want you to hit them. Hit them while you can, because they will hit you when they can. Mm-hmm. In this case, if the Dallas Cowboys give Dak Prescott $30 million a year, it would be the worst mistake that, in the history of the franchise that they've ever made.
No. You know I played there.
No.
They signed me. That was pretty
bad. You was the third. Yeah, I was like, one more. You was number three. It was one more after that. No, but if they do this, the reason why if they give him this type of money, it's going to take three to five years to recover from it, because now you're going to have to start trading defensive players away, trading old linemen away, other guys that should deserve to get paid. They won't get paid. And check this out. 48 regular season games, he's only thrown for 300 yards five times. Ever. In 48 regular season games. To me, that don't sound like a $30 million quarterback. It just don't. So if they go out and even offer or come close to $30 million, it's going to set these guys back for 3 to 5 years, and it'll be a horrible decision.
That's just the market rate, though, right? I mean, and we can look at all these.
Well, for average quarterbacks.
Yeah, but no, I mean, look at Wentz. Wentz just got paid 4 years. What is it? $128 million, right?
Yeah.
He hasn't done. I mean, okay, his game. You know, they've won games and different things like that. But as far as for what you see, what Dak has done, as far as for a team, I mean, I'll read a couple of stats for you in comparison to Wentz. Dak has 32-16. Wentz is 23-17. But Dak has won two divisional titles. He's the second most winning player since he's gotten into the NFL. But not only that, though, I think the big thing is
that running back, that defense, and they're a Super Bowl contender.
Yeah.
Period. Yeah. So I can't really compare these two guys, and I think it'd just be a horrible mistake.
Here's my take, and I'll let y'all answer if I'm right or wrong. The reason I'm real uncomfortable giving this dude $30 million is that once you do that, when he walks in that locker room, all of his teammates are gonna be like, you better deliver. It ain't gonna just be us carrying.
Pressure.
And so I think he's been very popular in that locker room while underpaid.
Yeah.
Once he gets paid, he's going to wish that he got treated the way Russell Wilson did when Richard Sherman and was lighting his ass up every chance they could. Them Cowboys players, when you run around making $30 million a year, that envy sets off, and then it's like, man, you better deliver like a $30 million guy.
If he's making 25, it's no different. You know what I'm saying? I just think we just have to understand that that's just the going rate for these quarterbacks at the moment. Does he deserve it? I think he does, just from that standpoint. I think from a winning perspective and just being He's played in every single game, yet you paying some of these other quarterbacks all this money and they not playing in half the games or whatnot.
There's a difference between 25 and 30.
There's a difference, but it's no different from the guy that's making five. He's still going to be envious, is my point. That's my point.
Get back in that locker room. We some big kids, bro. You know how we
Oh, I get it.
And we playing a child's game, man, and we grown. This is the same dynamic that happened in school. When the girl ain't that cute, everybody said, girl, pick your head. You all right? You fresh? You good?
Yeah.
Let her show up the next day feeling like she cute. You think you all that,
right?
Soon as I get that money, I'm fresh. They be like, oh, no, you ain't.
Right.
You better go out there and win some more games, throw for some more yards, throw for some more touchdowns. Here's the biggest issue that Dak has in his game. He's dressed up. They have one of the better lines, if not the best line. They have a great running game. They have a great defense. And Pro Football Focus, once again, I'm glad I didn't play, went out there and said the most predictive aspect of a quarterback is his ability to avoid throwing negative throws. And guess where Dak ranks? 25th.
Hey. Yep.
That means, bro, when everything goes right, what's your decision-making? It's not that good. It's below average.
So what's the biggest stat? What's the biggest stat, though? What's the biggest stat from this standpoint? Okay, his numbers might not necessarily be Peyton Manning or Tom Brady, but they're winning games. And at the end of the day, for quarterbacks, they always get the credit for winning games. I don't care how you slice and dice it. They're winning games.
Trent Dilfer got the credit.
The defense got a credit. I'm talking about three seasons now. I mean, you're talking about just one or two games.
Hey, are you helping us go forward, or are we pulling you in that direction of going forward? That's the conversation about Dak. Is he helping accelerate this team, or is this team pulling him along for the ride? And that's a $30 million question.
I'm agree with you. If I was Dak, I wouldn't even want $30 million. It's okay if you're a defensive player or whatever, you can't be exposed every play if you get that type of money. You might get beat on the pass coverage. You might not have double-digit sacks. You can kind of get hidden.
You can get away with it.
Being a quarterback making $30 million a year, every single play, every single game, it's on you. And if you don't live up to it, you're going to get questioned every single time.
And
you're going to do that anyways, though.
No, but you're going to do that. If he's making 15 a year, I mean, your question is going to be different if you're getting paid 30.
Listen, I think there's a huge difference. If he takes 25 and every time a broadcaster covers the game and has said, you know, Dak took a little less than his market value, as opposed to when he throws an interception in a clutch spot, I can hear Troy Aikman now. Boy, they paid this guy $30 million to make that throw, and he didn't.
Exactly.
So it's going to be part of the narrative. And I know what we're going to do on this show. $30 million?
I still think 25 too high.
How about this?
Whoa.
We fast forward to next year broadcast, and Troy Aikman says, yeah, Byron Jones, who left in free agency. Jalen Smith, who left in free agency.
Right.
But they got Dak, and then he throws that interception again. But you can't win. If I'm Dak, I'm not taking less. I'm betting on myself.
For sure.
But boy,
he's making a lot of money for wearing that star.
Right.
There's a lot of lose-lose situation for him, to be honest with you.
Off the field, you can make it up.
But you can make that money off the field still at 30 or 25. I'm trying to say what I'm saying is
you should be an agent.
I'm pro players getting their money now. It's just I think with Dak's situation, it is what it is. That's the market. But also for him, he's with the Cowboys, so of course there's more pressure. I just think for him, he just has to go out there and ball out regardless. But take your money, man. I don't care what nobody say. It's going to be pressure. Take your money.
All right, stick around. Later in the show, we'll give you our latest approval ratings for Dak, and Uncle Jimmy will tell us what he thinks of the Cowboys quarterback. Also coming up, Cam Newton and Carson Wentz are both under serious pressure to bounce back this year. We'll tell you which quarterback will be able to deliver.